This was a, I think we did this in class, right? This was a doubles. So when you're doubling and you're continuously compounding, that's a pert. With pert, you have to use ln as your inverse. Ln e is one of those properties that cancels out to 1. And that one shouldn't have been so bad. Round it the same way you would if you're graphing and doing an intersect, 3 decimals. If it's people, obviously a whole number. If it's money, 2 decimals. If it's time, when, give me 3 unless they ask you for the year. Okay, again, you were decreasing at this rate, so you have this formula. Again, could you divide both sides by this number? Absolutely. Cross off what you can, leave the rest in a fraction. Don't worry about reducing anything, just leave it as a fraction. So if you had this, and this is perfectly valid, just don't reduce this with a decimal. Could you simplify that? Yes, but why bother? If you make a mistake, then that's a mistake made. I would just leave it. Now take the log of both sides. And bring this down. And divide both sides by this mess. Right. And you'll get your answer. Same answer. Can you take the ln of both sides? Absolutely. Ln is universal. It can be used for anything. Like I said, most college books that you look in will probably use ln, just because it's easier to always use it since you have to use it for base E and you can use it for base any other bases. They pretty much always use ln. Good? You okay with these? Questions? Anybody have a question on this? Anybody's answer's not coming out the same? This is why we learned all of your logs to get to this, so that we can get that exponent to come down. This is why we go through that whole unit. Okay, determine how much time. Again, you had this. We're doubling, and we're compounding quarterly. There's your quarter. Works the same exact way. Take the log of both sides, bring down your exponent, and divide. Log, ln, either one. Doubling, if you put 200, 100, 2,000, 1,000, as long as you double, 2 to 1. Most of the time with the logs, it's all in like the fraction part, so just be careful with the fraction. You guys have the fraction key on most of your software, so that's very, very helpful. Before, maybe like 5-6 years ago, everything was based on parentheses because we kept putting parentheses on everything because we didn't have the alpha k, the alpha y equals k. I think that's only been available maybe 4 or 5 years. Have you guys had it that long? You don't remember it? So I think it's only been maybe 4 or 5 years. Okay, the number of bacteria doubles. Good morning.
What were you here yesterday? What happened?
I had a personal day. So we're going to isolate this. So we're going to divide, get rid of that 2,500. That divides out nicely. So do it that way. Like I said, you can do it either way. If you want to take the ln of both sides and then turn it into an add, it works the same way. Bring down your exponent. Now this one that we bring down has a denominator. Get rid of it. Multiply both sides by 3. When you multiply, you don't multiply this. You multiply the outside by 3. Then divide by ln2, and you get your answer. These answers should be the exact same as your graphs. This is the algebraic solution. stop me if you have any questions. I think this one we did in class. If double, you're doubling, so there's your factor of 2 every month. Divide by 20, that works out easy. Or take the log of both sides and turn it into an add. You can take the log of both sides. This only belongs to this guy, so this you have to separate into an add. Subtract this guy. And divide both sides by ln 2. Works the same exact way. Just watch the parentheses. Again, 3 decimal places. Is it? Okay. And this one's the last one. This one had a cycle in here every 14 days. When will it be less than? So we just said find, set the equal to, and then just say it has to be a little bit greater than that. And really technically that is not so too because we round it. But it's all we need to do. Can you divide both sides by 6.58 and leave it like a fraction? Absolutely. If you want to do this side like this, and then do this, and take the log of both sides, absolutely. Questions at all? Yes?
For number 3, when we write down our answer, would you want it as with the decimal, or do you want it to be like after a certain time?
I want it with the decimal. Technically, if they said in how many days are you less than 1 gram, then you're going to have to go to 39 days. If it just says when, time-wise, give me the decimal. So what I'm saying too is technically we rounded here, so because we're rounding, we're just going to say it's just greater than that. It's got to be greater than that. That's when it's equal. So any little bit more, and we're less. But if this should say, in how many days, like full days, then you got to go to 39. Mm-hmm. But the when part, just give me 3 decimals. We try not to make this. I don't know if I can write on this. Okay, so. Do I have a pen? Okay. So do you know how I write on this? This won't let me use a pen over here. It won't let me write on it. So 0.607, we said? Okay. Any questions on these other two? This is a good exercise for logs. This is the one where you have one log. You can't take it away. You can't put a log on the other side. This is the one that goes log equals exponent. 3 raised to the second power. I don't do mine the way they do it. They do theirs. So 3 raised to the second power equals x plus 1, which is this. 3 raised to the second power is 9. I don't know where this comes from. I don't do mine like that. You can raise this and then raise that. But I don't, it's easier to do it the other way. There's nothing wrong with the way we do it. Oh, you know why? It's a PDF and I can't somehow write on a PDF. Okay, so does everybody see that? I would bypass this and just do this 3 squared equals x plus 1. Okay? 5, 6, 7, again, they do it a little differently. I teach it the other way. 2 to the third equals 2x minus 3, and you're right there. 2x minus 3 equals 8.
make life easy. Ellen E, make sure you put the E in. Technically, you have two ways you can do this. You can pull the 4 up, and then when you take the log of both sides, that 4 is going to be coming back down. So technically you can do that. You can divide both sides by 4, whichever way you choose. I wouldn't do this. I would do e squared equals 3x. Just come right down to that statement. Divide by 3 and put it in your calculator. We go 3 decimals. The sheet just goes exact value. This one you have logs on both sides. If it's one term, you can take your logs away. So bypass this, don't do this, just take the logs away. So come right down to here. X is equal to 1 minus x. If you need me, I'll pull it on a different Word doc and I'll work them out with you. This. You didn't have a 7? Is this different than the sheet?
No, it's the same
problem.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, is it?
But ours is just not really good.
Oh, yeah, it is.
Oh, yours
is numbered very weird.
There's 2 fives, too. There's 2 fours.
Yeah.
We're in the same order, though.
But you're okay with this, the finding the answers? Okay, this one, you have 2 choices. You can pull it up first, or you can divide by 2. Then I would just do E to the 3 halves. I would come right down to here. Technically, they raise every power from to the E, so they raise both sides to the E. I don't do it that way. I just do E to the 3 halves. I make it easier. I don't teach this way. This guy, you have logs everywhere. So your goal is to bring it down to one log statement. When we subtracted, we divided. Now just remove your logs and come down to here. Cross multiply. And solve for x. I'll move it down. Cross multiply, solve for x. Remember, a domain here, x has to be greater than 0. This has to be greater than 0. So x has to be greater than 1. Can't be a negative 1. So this is not greater than 1, greater than 0. So you're got to reject that guy. This has a good one with ln. Bring this guy up. There's your exponent. This was an add, so it was a multiply. Once you get here, take the ln's away, you are right here. I think we did this one in class. This is the same one we did in class with the 6 and the 1. Mm-hmm. Yes.
I have a question on number 9.
Yes.
How come they turn the positive 2 to a negative
3? How come they turn the positive 3?
The word says x over, like 8x over x squared minus equals 3. Down to the next one. Yeah,
because they cross multiplied this. So cross multiplying it gave you 3x squared minus 3. This was fine, and then if they put this over 1 and cross multiplied this. So that's that product. And this one, I think we did this one in class. We might have had log that works the same way. Questions at all on any of these? Am I? How does E, which one are you here? E, I don't do mine like this. I put my base E here. Put your base E. You have 2 ways. They happen to divide by 2 first. So if you divide by 2 first, you say E, this is your base, raised to this exponent equals X. They raise both sides from E. I don't do that. I think it's more confusing, and I hate to see this up here. This does come out to be x, because e to the ln will come out to be 1. So technically, your x will come down. So I don't teach it this way. I think my way is simpler. I don't like to make logs too confusing, because they are confusing enough. So I keep it as easy as possible. Questions at all on any of these? Yeah. Oh, sure can. What number?
For number nine. I didn't do the end of question nine.
Question nine. This one?
Yeah.
Okay. So we had logs everywhere, so when we subtracted, we had a divide. So when you get to this point, take your logs away. You come right down to here. Just take your logs away, and it becomes a regular algebraic problem. Put it over 1 and cross multiply, and then solve for x. You got a factor. This is factoring. This isn't bad because these are both prime numbers, 3 and 3. So you only get one set of factors, 3 and 1. So if you set this up, there's only 2 tries it's really going to take you to do. Put a 3 and a 1 there, and a 1 and a 3, and if anything, switch the second part. A negative you can't have because we can't take the log of a negative number. But this is a mess. I don't teach this at all. Any other questions?
I just don't really understand how you know to put
So which one are you looking at?
Nine.
So let's get rid of this. I can't write on this. Let me just fill up just a sheet that I can get some blank papers on. So number 9. Your number 9?
The one that's 2 ln x.
Okay. Board is so sensitive. I can't even put my paper here. Oh, now I'm erasing. All right, so they divide it by 2. Or you can bring it up. Now, this looks like this. Do they all look the same? What's the difference between all 3 of these? They all have a base. Only one has a base that is showing. Right? So how would you solve this one? Yeah, log equals exponent. So you would say, what is your base? What is your exponent? Okay. So now, on this guy, do the same exact thing for this one. What is your base? 10. So that's why I say put it there. Mm-hmm. 10 to the 3 halves equals x. Same with this guy, it's a log. What is your base? E. That's where your base is. E to the 3 halves equals x. Didn't I say like the other day, this is the hardest ones when they don't put the base in there? When the base is not there, I have kids that sit there and stare at it. I come over while they're taking the test and they're like, I can do everything, but I can't do this one. I'm like, but you did the same exact problem before. And they look at it and look at it. Mostly, it's this one. Mostly, it's this guy. Most of the kids will get the E, but they can't get the 10. And so what they do is they just cross out the log. But you can't take logs away from one side. You can only take logs away from both sides. Or you can give logs to both sides. So since this has a log, you just can't put another log there. You change the equation. Same thing if I gave you this. I just can't get rid of this fraction, can I? Because I don't like it. I can't do that. I can multiply this by 2, can I? So if I do that, I get x. But I just changed my problem now. So I have to multiply this side by 2. I can't change the problem. I can modify it, but I can't change it. So on an equation, what you do to one side, you have to do to the other side. So in this guy too, you can't put a log here because you'd have to put another log here. And you can't say log of log. So the only way we do this one is to flip this one back. So you need to see the base there. So whenever it's missing a base and the word is log, put the 10. Whenever it has an ln, put the e. those are the ones, believe me, over the years of doing this, the kids just stare at that one and say, I don't know what I'm doing wrong. It works up here. Yeah, it still works. You just have to put the face on it. Any other questions with that? Any other questions that you have on locks? Anything that's confusing?
Can we use them a lot more in this course or just this unit?
This is it for your unit, but do you take physics? You guys in physics, do you use locks? I think in physics you will use locks. I'm pretty sure you do in physics. Because once my kids get the locks here, they do better when it comes to the physics part. You'll use locks like in engineering sometimes and things like that, but for us, we're done with it after this. And I'll be honest with you, what we did for exponents and for logs is no different than Algebra 2. This is an Algebra 2 worksheet. This is exact. Well, my whole curriculum for exponents and logs is exactly the same as yours from Algebra 2. We didn't add or enhance it at all. We didn't. But what happens is, Algebra 2, you learn something new every day, so it's overwhelming. So by the time you do it again, it starts to sink in. Colleges use a lot of locks.
So we do too.
But the raises.